Get ready to match the stars. Avery Shriver, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reddy, Kate Jackson, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flagg. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Reber.
Thank you, Jackie Olson.
And Fred.
It's Mr. Babbitt here. How's everybody?
Terrific.
We're fine.
You all right? Yeah. Richard, are you all right?
Top of the world, thank you.
That's good. Oh, look at what you're wearing. Hey, I want one of those.
I want two of those.
I've got a good job. I change the numbers every year.
Oh, terrific.
Time just flies away.
Yeah. Well, what do you say we greet our two players over here, Judy Norton and Warren Weinstock. Yeah. How are you?
Good.
Okay, Warren?
Fine, thank you.
Judy's a current champ. She's won a pretty good bundle of money, $350, one game, and she's being challenged by Warren. We are in the middle of our second and final round, and the score at this moment is 5-4. And you've got one question to go. You'll have to match one celebrity to stay in the game and achieve a tie. However, you match two or more, you will win. Okay?
Okay.
Well, do that in a minute or so, but right now we want to do this, especially for you. Ready? Here we go. Remember? One to tie, two to win. There are only two people who play, Brett and Charles. This is for you especially.
Brett and Fred.
What happened yesterday, huh?
Okay. I will come up here just to make sure that you hear every word I say. Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
There wasn't much news yesterday, so Walter Cronkite spent the last 15 minutes of his show blanking his mustache. Hello, darling. How are you?
I have it. I'm sure
okay.
I do.
All right, there, finished. Wasn't that a quick response? All right, Judy Norton, it's up to you. There wasn't much news yesterday, so Walter Cronkite spent the last 15 minutes of his show blanking his mustache.
Playing with?
Playing with his mustache? Just sat there on camera doing that?
I like that.
They're booing you, and maybe we'll find out why in a moment or so. I guess there are a couple of choices here. All right, Brett, you're up for...
What are you doing? Yes.
I just let it go wherever it wants.
That's right. It goes, and it's going all over your face there.
Yes.
All right, Brett, you're up.
Wonderful. What, am I the villainess?
No.
Oh,
no.
Good.
She needs one to tie, two to win.
Oh, well, we haven't yet tied. I said he spent the last 2 years waxing his mustache.
Waxing his mustache. Yes. No, now, playing with was good, waxing was also good, and you may have another one, but of course, playing with.
I have waxing.
Waxing
too.
Also. So, Warren wins the game. Congratulations. Judy.
Yeah.
Did you have a few laughs while you're up here?
Oh, yeah.
Good.
Lots.
We've got some money for you, $350, and our best wishes. Judy Norton, ladies and gentlemen. Goodbye. So, Warren, you ready?
Yeah.
See this thing here? You're going to have a go at over $5,000. Here's the way it goes. Step down stage here with me, attaboy. Now, we polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank trunk. The answer that group gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. If you match the middle one, you get $250, and the bottom one, $100. Three of the ding-a-lings are permitted to help. Whom do you call on?
Brett, please.
Brett, ding-a-ling number one.
What about vaudeville trunk?
What about it?
It stinks. That's what about it. It smells.
Yeah. All right. We've got to accept it because that's what she said.
Let's try Richard, maybe better.
Let's try Richard.
What do you have, dear?
Warren?
Yes.
I'm glad you called on me. Elephant's trunk.
Elephant's trunk. All right. That's two.
And how about Fanny?
How about Fanny?
Born in a trunk.
Fanny, you
didn't finish the line.
Fanny, we are too showbiz for this group.
Fanny,
you're
listen to me.
You're going to feel bad.
What? Your enthusiasm is marvelous. It's too bad the answers are so rotten.
Are you trying to tell me that I have snatched victory out of the jaws of defeat again?
That's what I'm trying to tell you. No, but that's your answer. Born in the trunk. It's a popular show business phrase. I don't know if that audience thought about it. We'll find out. Born in the trunk, elephant's trunk, and vaudeville trunk. Now, do you want to take one of those, or would you like to do your own?
Well, it'd be nice to do my own, but I'll take elephant's.
You can't think of anything?
No, as a matter of fact, I can't.
Keep trying, okay. Warren.
Elephant's trunk is what we're looking for. Watch. Let's come over here and find out if it's up there, and if so, where. Right. May we see the $100 response. Car trunk.
From the film, Born Free.
Put the body.
This is kind of a difficult one, I think. Car Let's trunk. Be kind to them now. Here we go. Looking for elephant's trunk is the $250 response. Tree trunk. Now, that's a good one.
Tree
trunk is a good one. I got to admit that. We didn't think of that. That's a good one.
Born in.
Last chunk. For, last chance
born
for
in.
Elephant's trunk.
Hope that's born
Here
out.
Is the $500 response. Elephant's trunk.
You picked the right one.
Okay, Richard gave it to you. Okay. Now, Warren, you're going to play for 10 times $500 or $5,000. Remember, do you have to match one of them head-to-head? Has to be an exact answer. Whom do you call her?
Richard, please.
Okay.
Oh, I was just
choose,
a little bit off.
Choose Fanny. She was close.
You face me, if you would, please, sir. And Richard will get ready to write. This is it. Here we go. Magic blank. Magic blank. We appreciate your enthusiasm, audience, but please do not give answers because your answer may be lousy. And then you're going to influence both of these people up here. Magic blank. He's finished. Okay, Warren Weinstock, we need an answer from you which you think will match his. Magic blank.
Magic wand.
Wand. I knight thee, Sir Warren. Okay, Richard.
You were a lot.
He's going to wave his magic wand and make you have the same answer that he wants you to have.
He'll have to wave it a lot. To wave it for about 4 days. There was Magic Castle and Magic Mountain, and I thought of Magic Trick.
Magic Trick, yeah.
Yeah, there are many good choices.
Many
there.
Of them. Okay, there's also so Magic there? Fingers that Brett uses at the motel.
Oh, that's right. Is when you put the quarter in the machine there. Okay, so Warren, you've got $600 all together. You're going to meet another player in a minute or so, but right now we're going to meet this message of considerable interest. Oh, we're not going to. Ready? Here we go. Now we're ready to play another game, and we very happily welcome Gina Long. Hello there.
Hi.
You're a very pretty lady, Gina. Please tell us a little bit about yourself.
Okay, I was born and raised in Phoenix, Scottsdale area of Arizona.
Yeah.
Where I lived up until about a year ago when I made the move to the big city of Los Angeles.
Yes.
I'm a model, and I've studied classical ballet since I was very small.
Classical ballet is not funny. It's a very serious thing. What are you?
Well, they're all dancing
oh, yes.
people.
Would you like to see my turnout?
Yes.
You see my? How about that
Excellent.
For a turnout?
Excellent. But we don't walk all the time with our.
Yes, we do. Feet. We always walk like this.
And the first thing you know, we get arrested.
Walk like this, right,
Gina?
Yes.
That kept Gina out of the army, darling. That's
Oldest jokes worth
I enjoy people, and I love little children,
love
but I'm becoming increasingly more active working with high school youth group.
How do you
I
feel about older men? You ready?
Yes.
Okay. Gina, are you married?
No, I'm not.
I think you're going to do quite well again.
All right. Good luck to Gina, and good luck to Warren. Let's begin. Gina, which number, 81A or B here?
I'll have A, please.
A it is. Here we go. New game everybody plays. The archaeologist said, this mummy is definitely a fake. It's not wrapped in old cloth. It's wrapped with blank. The archaeologist.
Gina, what will you say, and then I'll...
The archaeologist said...
I nodded off through that whole question. As soon as you said archaeologist, yes, my little eyes just got
that's
so
Bing,
heavy.
Right. Well, I'm have to take away your Perrier.
I know.
The archaeologist said this mummy is definitely a fake. It's not wrapped in old cloth. It's wrapped with blank.
Oh, I understand that.
Finally got through to you, eh?
Oh.
Wrong.
You just mind your own business. Remember the other day when we had drowning?
Yes.
And it was a match.
No whispering.
No whispering.
My spelling
doesn't count here. We don't
care. Oh, what do we have? Another Joanne Flug on her hands down there in the dummy seat?
Okay, everybody. Avery, finishing up.
Stand up here in the...
Put it in the slot now, Avery.
Oh, that one.
All
that's
right.
It. Bye.
All right. Now...
He always wears that at Halloween, so no one will recognize him.
Jenna, the archaeologist said, this mummy is definitely a fake. It's not... Excuse me, I have to sneeze.
Hachoo!
God bless you.
I repressed it. They say you can get a hernia that way. The archaeologist said, this mummy is definitely a fake. It's not wrapped in old cloth. It's wrapped with... blank.
Oh, I'm going to say wax paper.
Waxed paper.
I'm sorry.
Leave her alone.
Turn on her.
I'll turn her on.
All right, she said waxed paper. What do you say, Avery?
Close. No, I said sandpaper. So.
Sandpaper.
So that's two rotten answers in a row, Brett.
Whose mummy was she?
I don't know. Not my mummy.
I said saran wrap.
Saran wrap.
Those are my people out there.
Charles, they go for saran wrap.
I go for saran wrap, too. Wax paper went out with the last World War, didn't it?
Yes.
The day his hair fell out.
What do you say?
I said scotch tape.
This mummy is wrapped in scotch tape. Got some winners up here, folks. Yes. A little fever.
Temperature seems to be racing.
Yes, right.
Scotch tape.
Scotch tape.
That went out with sandpaper. Al Serrano.
Saran wrap.
Very close.
All sorry, right. Gina. Now, Fanny Flagg.
Man from Glad. I said saran wrap.
Saran wrap. So, well, you were on the... You really
I was on the right track.
You were thinking of the right thing, but... Well, all right, Warren, you ready for yours?
Sure.
Hey, you know when Noah...
Yeah.
Threw the big cocktail party on the Ark.
Yeah.
I was there.
You were there. I'll have you know. He used one of the pelicans as a blank.
Oh! Yeah. Don't
worry
about it.
Had a big cocktail party aboard the old Ark. And he used one of the pelicans as a blank.
I'm finished.
Good. All right.
I wasn't really there.
Oh, this is a very easy one. And some very interesting possibilities, too. And amusing ones. Okay, Warren. When Noah threw the big cocktail party on the Ark, he used one of the pelicans as a...
Cocktail shaker.
As a cocktail shaker.
Oh, you're my friends.
Right up there with wax paper.
All right, Avery.
Now, I just thought this one over logically.
Yeah.
And I came up with an ice bucket.
Ice bucket is good.
Yeah.
No.
Yes.
Boy, well, what do pelicans wear?
Feathers.
Snowshoes.
Pelicans wear feathers.
Tuxedos pelicans wear.
Those are penguins. Those are penguins, dummy. You thought you've been thinking of a pelican, and in your mind you got a picture of a penguin.
Uh-huh.
So what'd you write?
Guess. I wasn't really at Noah's Ark party.
You weren't?
I wasn't invited.
Oh.
I said waiter.
I see.
I thought that was... Thank you, sweetheart.
He's the pelicans as a waiter, eh? Okay, Charles.
You know, I was sailing the other day, and I saw a pelican. But I saw a tuxedo this time, and I said bartender.
A bartender.
I'm yes. so glad.
You blew it also, eh? I hope you understood it.
I forgot what I wrote. Yeah.
Penguin. Well, no, through the big cocktail party on the Ark, you used one of the pelicans as a...
Punch bowl.
Punch bowl is good. Punch bowl and cocktail shaker, unfortunately, do not match. You're getting close, though.
I would like to hear more of that sailing adventure of Charles.
Yes.
It sounded so exciting.
He's on the ark.
You know what a silent butler is, don't
yes,
you?
Yes, of course.
Little thing where you take your basic pelican.
Right.
And grab it.
Squeeze him.
By the head.
No, by the other end.
Oh, by the other end.
You go...
And then you dump the ashtray.
I see. It's an excellent idea if you're ever on the ark. Please feel free to use it.
Fanny Flagg, looking for cocktail shaker.
I'm happy for you.
I said the same thing. Ashtray.
Got a pitcher's duel going here, zip to zip. I don't want to say we got two dummies up here, but it's zip to zip. There it is. Okay. We'll get back to you because we got no choice. In a minute or so. Ready for round two. Here we go. Now, Jenna, what do you say?
I'll try B.
B
this
it
time,
is.
Please.
You've got it. Arthur, everybody plays. Arthur said to the psychiatrist, Doc, there must be something wrong with me. As soon as I walked into the group therapy session, all the other patients blanked.
There must be something wrong with me.
As soon as I walked in the group therapy, you're the best.
I'm the first.
You're the first. As soon as I walked into the group therapy session, all the other patients blanked.
That's my answer.
Past tense.
I know. I'm writing in the past tense.
That's what we're after.
You're living in the past tense.
You are the past tense.
Oh, that's true, isn't it? I try not to ever think about it.
No, you're a sweet lady.
I've never met a pelican she didn't like.
All right, Jenna. Arthur said to the psychiatrist, Doc, there must be something wrong with me. As soon as I walked into the group therapy session, all the other patients blanked.
All right. My first response was they left, walked out.
They like that.
But then when you said past tense, that didn't
If the audience likes it,
is it a bad omen.
No, I'm only kidding.
Smart answer.
Yeah, that's a very good answer she gave, Avery.
Yeah. This has happened to me. They flipped.
That doesn't match.
That doesn't match?
But that's an interesting answer, though.
Yeah.
Brett, what do you say?
That little girl is just a terrific little person, a fine human being. I understand a good kisser, a marvelous dancer, and I said fled.
Fled or left? There's a match. That's one for you, Jenna. Charles?
No, Gina's pretty enough to be a movie star.
Yes, she is. She's a very pretty
lady. What's her name?
So are you, Charles.
Gina Long.
Gina Long.
A Brigida.
Then a...
A Brigida. Oh.
Gina Long or Brigida? Well, it's better than those t-shirts down on the first row. I said recovered, what I wish for every patient, which is a
recovered.
Sweet answer.
Yes, it's a very sweet answer. But doesn't do much for Gina, does it?
No.
All right. As soon as I walked into the group therapy session, all the other patients blanked, and she said left, which was a rather stunning answer.
She said walked out. Yeah. So did I.
That's it. There's another one for you. All right. Would you like to help this young lady along, Richard, with a smashing answer?
Who said long or Brigida?
Charles.
How disgusting. Is it past tense?
Yes.
All right, then lefted.
Lefty. Okay, that's three for Jenna. Now we come to Fanny Flagg.
I've never been in group therapy, but Brett told me all about it.
Really?
And the main thing is people discuss their lives. And so I said when he walked in, everybody else shut up.
Okay. So you matched half of the celebrities there, and now we go to Warren's question. And no? You want to do a commercial? No. All right. We'll put that right back there, Warren. And you'll stand by for a moment while we do this message of considerable interest to all. Now, time is up. I'm sorry to say we've just got to stop the game right here in the middle of round two. And you'll have a chance. When we come back next time, you're going to have to match three celebrities to stay in the game. Four will win another game. Look forward to seeing you both next time. And you too. Now, let's see. We got a little time here. Is there anything we can do for you? What's the name of that show you're in?
Rookies.
Rookies, yeah.
I had Masquerade Party, number one in Guam at the moment.
That's right.
Yes, Charlie. And a friend in the audience, Avery's mother, Minnie Schreiber.
Minnie Schreiber's in the audience. Yeah.
That's a small Schreiber.
Yes. All right. Well, no.
I did the Mike Douglas show.
When did you do that?
Almost. I'm leaving on Tuesday.
You're doing it without Dawson and me?
Well, I did it last week.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
With whom?
With Bill Bixby and Joan Rivers.
Oh, isn't it? Bill Bixby and all his fascinating friends. News,
I had Chinese food about 2 weeks ago.
Team Reverend Match Game 75. Join us next time. Thank you. Goodbye.
Over most of the CBS stations.